I have no real reason to have this shot. My camera just sort of turned on. But the clouds are cool. Well, let's make this important. I'm right outside Chad's gym. I don't know if it has an official name yet. But we're going to explore this today. Oh, now that sun's right in my face. Let's go back to the clouds. Although today I'm all alone playing here, on any given day there could be half a dozen people doing all sorts of strong stuff here. And you can tell by the toys that there's a lot of strong to be had, because everything here is heavy and most of it's a little weird. Part of that includes, and this is what I'm excited about today, this thing. I'm going to throw something over that. I'm going to take a little baby keg, a little pony keg, and toss it over that. Or at least I'm going to try. Let's see how it goes. So I've thrown a lot of kegs and sandbags. That's about, I don't know, 14, 16 feet. I don't know if I've ever done anything quite that high. So let's give it a go. But I'm going to point out something cool first. The grounds here are just nothing but woods and woods and woods and woods. And while I've been filming today, because I've been filming for both my website and for you, there's been deer that have been popping out of this the whole time. So we'll see if we see any deer today. There, maybe you can see that one crossing the road. But let's throw. Yay! Okay, so that was the first try, and it was successful. It went up and over that. Awesome. Happy about that. But then it rolled down this hill and went through one barbed wire fence and possibly a second. Just so you know, there's the thing that I threw it over. And it's still way back behind me. Way back in the woods. You know me and woods, I'm all about it. You can't even see it back there, but it's not sure how to get past this little fence here though. There's the keg. There's where it was. So we're gonna throw it the other way this time. I can explain it best from a music point of view. If you're part of a music scene, there's always going to be that one guy who supports everybody. If you have a show, even if nobody's going to your show, if you're in a band, you know that one guy is going to be there. And you're always so grateful that that one person is there. There's that one person who loves music, loves the scene, loves everything about it so much that even if your band sucks, they're going to be there rooting for you. Well, that's Chad with Strength Sports. He's at every event. He's at every strongman meet, powerlifting meet, Highland Games meet that he can be at. He came to Russia with us with the Moss team just to ref and to help the team out and to be very supportive of the team. He was at my last two strongman meets in California just for the hell of it, just to go support and help and judge and ref and do everything he could to be part of the experience. And next weekend, he's gonna be at a meet that I know about, which we'll talk more about in a little bit. And so I got to know him pretty well, and he has an open door policy. Come play at his place. Come get strong with him, and I will. He is the most supportive person in strength sports currently. If you want somebody in your corner, just call Chad. If you need somebody to help you at a meet, just call Chad. If you need somebody to coach you at a meet, or just to load plates at a meet, or to judge a meet, just call Chad. Hell, he'll bring equipment. He'll bring food. You just let him know there's something happening. He's gonna be there to support you. We'll see if we get him on camera today or not, but I did wanna show you his amazing gym. Lord knows we can use more people like that in the world right now. You live with a body all damn life. You said you couldn't go without it, neither comes in a walk of shame.